How are we doing, everyone? Odin here from Tactical Edge Hobbies, and today we're going to talk about how to maintain your gas blowback pistol. Okay, so here on the tech bench with us today, I've grabbed the two most used demonstrator pistols we have in store. I've got a Glock 17 style WeTech gas blowback pistol here, and a High Kappa or 2011 WeTech gas blowback pistol on this side. I'll start with the 2011 or High Kappa. Now, with any pistol, when you go to clean it, the first thing you need to do is remove the mag. They don't come apart with the magazine. So, magazine out, and we'll set that over to the side for now. Next thing we need to do on the 2011s is we need to line up the half moon shape indent in the slide that we have just here, and then bring that back till it lines up just perfectly with the top of the slide catch. From there, when we flip it over, we have a little pin just here. If we push that out, you'll see that the slide catch has now popped out slightly on this side. We remove that, and we set that to the side as well. From there, we can slide our barrel forward, and we keep coming forward, and it'll come completely off the pistol. Okay. First thing I always recommend whenever you open up your pistol is grab a cheap microfiber rag. You can buy these from your local big box hardware stores. Simply grab that, and what you're trying to do here is go through and take any of the old lube off. So a bit of lube through here. You're looking for any dust, dirt, gel particles from shattered gels, things like that. You want to clean that all out. It doesn't need to be spotless. You just want to make sure that you get any of the grit out, because the grit will eventually start wearing the metal as well. So we're simply just cleaning it all out like so. Now, if I look at the lower, first thing we want to notice is any black sections of metal, such as this, that have started to turn silver. So we have two little spots just here, as you can see. That's where the metal on metal has been rubbing. Now, tiny little spots like that is nothing to be concerned about. That's exactly normal. When you start seeing excessive wear and material being worn away on these rails, both front and back, that's an indication that you've got a problem, and it's only going to keep getting worse. And I would suggest bringing your pistol in for us to have a look at, assess and repair. So I'm very happy with the lower in that. It's all nice and clean. There's no significant wear in any location. It's all still very much factory with a little bit of wear there, which, as I said, is completely normal. If we move to the slide, I always recommend taking the recoil spring and the barrel out of slides when you're doing a quick service on them. It just makes life so much easier. Now on the High Kappas, you want to put your finger into this small notch right here. You'll then be able to pull the spring retainer back. From there, hold that back, angle the rod out, and you have it there. Now, keep in mind that, of course, is spring loaded. This thing will shoot across the room on you. So once we have that out, we want to make sure our inner barrel section here, being the black part, so the silver is the outer barrel that you can see. The black section is connected to the inner barrel. Make sure they're nice and free, and then slide everything forward, and it'll come straight out the front like that. And again, grab your microfiber cloth, wipe out any areas where there's already grease. And again, we're looking for any silver parts, essentially, is the easiest way to explain it. If you can see raw metal, that is where you've had some wear, and they're the areas that we want to look at and figure out if it's normal wear or if it's excessive. So if we have a look at this one, straight off the bat, I have some extremely minor wear in sections here on these rails. Fraction just there, nothing to be concerned about. Other than that, that looks good. I would say that that's going to have a long and healthy life, and it's been maintained fairly well. Now, maintaining it. When it comes to the maintenance of pistols, we use two different types of lubricants. We use an oil for the air seals and plastic areas, and we use a grease for the metal on metal contact. So far as oil goes, you have a couple of options. You can use any good grade, reasonably thin silicone oil. You want it so that it is runny. Or you can use something like our WeTech spray oil. Now, this is a little bit more cost effective. This is a little bit quicker to use. In this video demonstration, I'll use this. Wherever I'm spraying this, you would typically use a drop of this. Sometimes when you use a drop of this, it's too much, and you might want to just quickly touch it up with a cloth just to take a little bit off. You'll see how much lubricant I use as we go on. So our nozzle, it's moving forward and back quite well. There is a spring that has to snap these nozzles back, so you want to slide that forward and let go and check the snap. That's sliding very freely and it's snapping back exactly where we want to go. So what I do from here is slide that forward, grab your silicone oil, whether it be the liquid or the spray, and just put a tiny little bit down into the back section here where this would normally cover over. Just like that. Bring that back, tiny little bit through the port, and just usually for only for a bit of good measure, I put a little bit down the sides here. So with the spray oil, you only need one shot, and that's that. That there, as you can see, is now quite shiny with lube. There's lube everywhere. I will go through and just quickly wipe off just a touch. You just want to take off any excess because we don't want to build up of lubricant in there, otherwise it will turn into sandpaper essentially. From there, grab a high quality synthetic lube. There is multiple lubricants out there on the market. In this case, I happen to have a tube of Super Lube. I would always recommend a grease for the metal on metal areas. They're essentially an oil with additives. So in this case, what the additives do is PTFE embeds into the metal and it actually stops the wear of metal to metal surfaces, which is why we're seeing significantly reduced wear on our demonstration pistols. What's happening is as the slide is recoiling, it's wearing away at that PTFE that comes in the lube and not the metal in our pistol. That's why it's important to remove the old lube and refresh it every now and then, because it does wear out. So grab your tube of lube, tub, whatever it is that you may have. I don't recommend a mineral-based lubricant, so your normal gun oils or anything like that. They don't go well with the rubbers and plastics that we see inside air-operated or gas-operated pistols, I should say. Always use synthetic. There is multiple options out there. I personally have used Battleborne break-free synthetic lubricant with PTFE in it. I've used for a long time now Super Lube with PTFE in it. When it comes to fast moving metal and metal components, you always want some sort of a lubricant with an additive in there that's going to enhance that. PTFE works perfectly on this application. So cheap and nasty paintbrush, grab a small bit of lube on the end of that, and all you want to do is on areas where the slide's going to touch, so these rails here, and the undersides of them, just give them a little bit of a touch up with a bit of lube. Make sure you get it in there nice and well. You don't want any globs floating around like that. Just paint it in there. Same up the back here. And when you're putting it on, you can go fairly freely and just spread it around with the brush. What you're looking for at the end of the day is a nice even coat over any areas that are going to have metal on metal contact. So I've applied here. You can see I've covered the entire rail area on both top and front and back. I've overspread here a little bit, but that's not an issue. Microfiber cloth, cleaned up. So I would typically just go through now, wipe up any excess and any globs, take any lube out from areas where it doesn't need to be, for example. There's no need for a lubricant in here. If you're not seeing areas of wear, it doesn't need lubricant. So I would now call that good. Our slide, we do very much the same thing, a little bit more lube, and we paint the rails. Full length of the rails get painted. So that's now spread nice and evenly throughout the pistol. Rails, you can see I've got excess on the top here, a little bit of excess through there. So then I'll just take my cloth, wipe down the side rails, wipe down the center there, and that's good. So now we reassemble. We have our inner and our outer. They separate like that. There is no real need to separate them. If they do separate on you, simply slide them back together and they do a little bit of a turn. Give them a bit of a wiggle. There we go. So they pop into place with just a tiny little bit of a turn. That then slides through the front of the slide, like so. We then grab our spring and our retainer, compress those back down, front end in first, let the retainer pop in, and then we locate that roughly center on the slide. So that's now ready to go back together. Slide that back onto our frame. Nice and gently, seems to work perfectly. We grab our slide catch and we drop that through the hole. And again, we want to line up our half moon cutout, and then we just simply press down, and that's now done. That pistol's back together. Give it a few wraps and you'll immediately notice that once you've done that, things get significantly smoother. So I'll set this to the side and we'll move through to the Glock pistol, and then we'll move on to the basic maintenance of magazines.
All right guys, we're gonna pull that video up here. It got a little bit longer than I planned, so for the next part of the video where we actually go through a Glock, stay tuned for the next Tuesday's Tech Talk. And in the meantime, like, comment, subscribe. Don't forget to smash that notification button. Catch us on Facebook. We also have a Discord channel that I'll link down below. And in the meantime, get out there, maintain your blasters, have a great day and play some gel ball. I'm Odin, and this is Tactical Edge Custom Shop.